No, she isn't. All right. Well, congratulations. You made it this far in the process. Let's see, we built skid. We've got reels on. We spooled up a extension cord. We have, it's time to put the regulators on. All right. So, we, at Alumareel, we've gone with FlameTech. FlameTech is our go-to company. Check them out. FlameTech, Instagram, social media. They're there. And they're good. They're great. All right. Enough on that. So, what we have in front of us is the three regulators that we're going to put on this skid package that we're currently building. We've got an oxygen, we've got an acetylene, and we've got an inert shielding gas. Inert shielding gas. However, you got four boxes back here. We also have the fuel gas, which is propane. So for you guys that preheat, guys and gals that preheat, or you want to run a pair burner or whatever it is that you do, when you do what you do with that propane, there that regulator go for you. And we got a reel, throw you a propane hose on it, and you ain't got to worry about milk crating it anymore. Okay. Inside each one of these boxes, when you go to unbox it, this is what you're going to find, right? That's what you're going to find in this box right here. You'll find the regulator, the stainless steel braided lines, high pressure braided lines, 5,000 PSI. You'll get a 60-inch and a 36-inch line. It'll come with a protector dust cap on it. This line will already be attached. It's already got the nipples and the ends on each regulator that's appropriate for that bottle. This is what the oxygen looks like. It's real nice, got a high pressure and an output. It also comes with a high flow flashback arrestor, right? Pretty self-explanatory. If you have issues with it, let me know. I'll help you out. Okay, acetylene. Get a good look at the acetylene one, right? High pressure, output flow. Again, stainless steel braided line, pre-assembled, the right nipple for it. Little rubber padding on the back, you'll understand why, and then a T-handle. Here in a little bit, you'll understand why. All right, again, 60-inch stainless steel line. All regulators come with a 60-inch on one side and a 36-inch on the other side, stainless steel braided lines. This one comes with the acetylene high flow flashback. And then, this is our newest addition to the family, the inert regulator. This thing's cool. It's been field tested by some of the best. Brother Nick Bazzotti's is a guy that has tested this out, and he is he's like an amazing, amazing individual. Look him up on Instagram, Nick Bazzotti's. If you have any questions, he field tested this in some pretty harsh conditions and did some posts on it. But what he really likes about it, he's an engineer. Don't tell no one. He really liked the way that this regulator performed in certain humidity / temperature conditions. He said that this one was the only one that didn't freeze up, and some of the store-bought shelf models from the other companies would freeze up or ice over. He said this one, good to go, Randy. Send it. So, this is what the inert looks like. Line, correct. And your secondary line. All right, your output line. No flashback arrestor on that. All right, let's get on the business. Let's go put these things on. You gonna come with me? Dance with me. Bee Gees is playing. Love me some Bee Gees. I don't know if that hit me further. We're gonna do this on the, okay, great point. Thanks for asking that. There's two ways that you can your tree, right? Your three tree. You can install these regulators two ways: laying down or the stand-up method. This is the stand-up method. We're gonna do the stand-up method. However, let me show you what the lay down method, what you'd need to do for that. Get your workbench. Sorry, I didn't mean to drop you on the head right there. Get your workbench, get your couple set of 2x4s, space them out, set your tree face down on there, then you can start from the top side, put your regulators in to where they're laying on it, then grab your back plate, put on it, and what this does is just give you some room. However, that is a method that makes the regulator a little bit cumbersome and a little bit heavy, and you got all the stainless steel lines hanging out there like tentacles when you're trying to put this on and hold your bolts in. So I'm going to show you a trick. I'm going to show you a better way to do this. Let me back you up a little bit. Y'all look at my grill. Okay, so let me show you a better way to do this. And it involves a couple zip ties. Man, I tell you what, JJ the boss has nailed it when he said zip tie. Can't outrun old zip tie. All right. Let me grab some regulators and I'll show you what I'm talking about. Don't go nowhere. Don't move. Coming right back. Here it comes. And what we're going to do is we're going to start with the oxy. We'll start with the oxy. So I'm bringing the oxy to us. All right. I'm going to put this down for a second. I'm going to set this one down for a second. Now, the oxy, you can put them in any order you want. Me personally, I like to separate it by colors. Just because it'll help, you know, kind of could help clear up any confusion in the heat of the moment when you're trying to get in there and get work done. So what I just did, slipped it in from the back, put it in the seat. This ring, it'll fit right in there nice and neat. Then I'm gonna take this zip tie, I'm gonna come around the back, and all I'm doing is coming around the neck of the gauges. I'm not going, and I'll show you here in a second. All I'm doing is just, see, it's still loose, I'm just holding it in place. The reason I'm doing that is so it won't fall out, and I can put my back plate on after I get all three of them zipped in, put my back plate on, bolt it in, snip the zip ties, pull the zip ties out like stitches, and then they're in place. Now I can work, it's already in, and less weight at one time. Let me grab the other ones. One more, on the back. Okay. Now, like I said, I like to alternate my colors. So, the next one we're gonna go with is the acetylene, because it's red. I mean, such a great song. Okay, again, just underneath the regulator, but not on top of the body of the housing, slipping around the neck of the gauges. And it ain't gotta be tight. It's gotta be enough to just kind of hold it in place. Right, nice regulator. Going with the inert on top. More zip ties. All right. Boom. Okay, now let's grab the backing plate because that's what's next. Backing plate, right? It's going to sit with this angling towards the machine side, all right? And it's all we're gonna do is sandwich. All we're gonna do is sandwich this. There's a little clip, a little hole, and all, okay? So, there's a bag of, let me show you this real quick. I tell you, there's a bag of nuts that come with this. And these right here is what's in it. These long ones, carriage bolts, they're gonna go through the backing plate, past the regulators and into the front. And then these two little boogers here, with a little angle piece at the bottom of that backing plate, that's where they're gonna go to hold that in. So, easiest thing to do, and the safest thing to do is probably grab one of these sets first. And just to hold this thing in place, because it's just sitting up there, I'm just going to put one in, smooth side to the front, ram in the slip one on the back, sure my little hole is in the top. Okay, now we put these two little boogers down here in the back side. Again, 9/16. Like 9/16. Now, in one of the previous videos, what I had told you is that sometimes a powder coat will get in the threads on this main bracket. So if you can, chase them before you send the bolts. It's a 9/16 standard thread. If you can, chase them with a tap. All right. We got two of them back here. We're going to honker them down. Now that you got those in there, now we can cut the stitches. All right. Now, you know what? Better to be safe than sorry. Let's just go ahead and loosely put these in. And just finger snuggle. Y'all having fun so far? This has been good fun. Sorry for all the dead time. Okay, now let's cut our zips. Pull them out. Pull them out the smooth way. Alright. Boom. Now. Okay. Now, all I'm going to do from this point forward is I'm going to grab my little impact and I'm going to start in the middle. And all I'm going to do is line my gauges to where they look centered up. Then I'm just going to real lightly start snugging up the bolts in the back. Just a little more pressure, just so I can line these out a little bit. See how that looks? Now I can come through and snug them down. You ain't got to do a bunch. Again, Loctite is highly recommended on all your bolts and nuts. Look pretty good, huh? Okay. Tighten these up here, just a little bit of pressure on them. Right. Try to show you over here on this side. Okay, here's a good one. See, this has the 90 that's coming out. They all have the same thing. 90 that's coming out, 90 that's coming out. All right, now. Let's put the outlet sides on. Alright. I know this is a dumb question. Which one's the oxygen, which one's the fuel? Trust me, I've had people ask me, well, it won't screw up. There's a memo. Alright, fuel. It's got the line in it. All fuel gases will have that line in it. Reverse thread, so reverse backwards, tidy, righty, lefty, loosey, opposite with that one, with the fuel. Okay, so it's on the outlet side is where we're going to put, the flashbacks. Okay, so let's go ahead and put those on first. This one is oxy. Tells you which way the direction of flow is going out. So pull our dust cap. Okay, I'll come back to that one. Let's put the acetylene on. Now, one thing to note, if this is pointed in the wrong direction and it's up against the face of your machine, just loosen this up and then the whole thing will tilt up. I think this one's loose. Yep, it's loose already. So you'll see a lot of these things will be up, pointed up like this, or pointed down, depending on what kind of machine you have and what kind of space you have. So let me grab a little thingamajigger remover. Let me see if I can do this without screwing some cords up and wasting a whole bunch of everybody's time. Okay, perfect. All right, back to the oxen. Okay. Standard size 11/16 and 5/8. So I'm gonna go ahead and angle these up a little bit because I know I'm putting a little 260 MPX on this skid system. So not that I need the room, but I am gonna put a air compressor. There will be an air compressor on the back of it too, as well. So, that's the inert. So the inert is right across from us, but we'll go ahead and angle it. Oh, we'll angle it up as well. Again, there's no flash off for that one. All right, let's turn our lines on. No lines, it's gas. I mean, it's oxygen. So, there is no one end or the other that belongs. Whatever you want, whichever end. It's all good. Boom. When you start putting all this together, it's going to turn into a little bit of a rat's nest, but just kind of place everything to where you most like it. Zip tie it up. There's nothing wrong with zip tying. Boom. And here's what's cool about the inert. I put the right tip on to fit in the fitting that comes on our standard on our reels. So, can't get that one confused. Now from here, all you're going to do is run your lines. You're going to run your lines out to the appropriate regulators. Take your lines to your right ones. All right, so here is my oxy, my output. coming up here with oxy reel. I know this one's the, I know this is the right one because there's no lines in it, so this is the oxygen side. Now I like to roll, I like to put a little loop in my line just so that I can start to hide this braided line because it gets pretty stiff. It don't matter where the loop's at because you can roll it down, roll it up. Again, put a little loop in it, gives you the ability to hide that thing. Zip ties, put all that stuff up. All right, last but not least is my shielding gas. Again, a nice little loop in it. Feeder in. Now, not necessary to put tape on this stuff, because it's all compression fittings. And for those that know, if you put tape on a compression fitting thread, you won't let it seal correctly. And now again, do those however. Actually, I'm gonna loosen this one up and face it down. Yes, sir. Boom. Now, I can hide all that stuff. And then, of course, you got your outlets. Got your outlets on the right side here. So, 22 minutes into this. Hopefully, y'all have fast-forwarded through a bunch of this junk. But, sorry, it takes a few minutes to put this stuff together. It is what it is. There's your regulator tree. Questions, comments, leave them below. See you on the next one.